Hello and welcome to Real Food. Joining me today from Brunello Italian Kitchen is the owner and also the head chef, Domenick Maresca. Domenick, thanks for coming back.
Thanks for having
me. You're like a fan favorite. You know, people love when you're on and stuff. And I think people love going to your restaurant, too,
yes.
Because I meet so many people who tell me they go up to Brunello. I was thinking of that this morning. You know, Brunello is not really like a new restaurant anymore. I mean, you've been around for a number of years
now,
right?
Yeah, this is my fourth year now in business.
Yeah. It's amazing.
So far, so good.
It's really caught on, right?
Yeah.
People love it, and it's a great place.
Yeah.
Let everybody know. I know we're on all over the country, but if you're in New York, it's located?
It's 1945 Deer Park Avenue in Deer Park, New York, just north of the train trestle, which is Long Island Avenue.
Yep.
Across from the shopping center, CVS.
All right, there you go. So you can stop by and visit and take a look. What I like about the place, you know, Domenick has a very interesting menu, so in this place. You know, it's Italian, but it's sort of Italian a la you, in a way. You know, it's a little different than just your basic Italian, right?
Yeah, I like to put a little twist on things.
Yeah, a lot of different things like
nice.
That. And I mean, and you have some traditional stuff that's very, very popular. Name some of your traditional.
Yeah, we have a jumbo veal meatball that's stuffed with ricotta and baked
well.
With mozzarella. We have our scarpriello
chicken,
which is a delicious dish. We have an open-faced train wreck lasagna, which is pan-baked lasagna right in a pan. We have a few good dishes, cavatelli. Ragu with pulled short ribs stewed in a tomato sauce, another fan favorite, really good.
Yeah, and I love all of that. And again, it's traditional, but also a little bit different, you know?
Yeah.
How about learning to cook? Where did you learn to cook?
Growing up, I cooked my whole life. You know, my grandmother, they're all Italians, you know, waking up Sunday morning to hearing the pots and pans at 5 o'clock in the morning,
course, right?
Smelling the sauce and meatballs.
So
it's been in the family, and I just, my whole life, I had a passion for it. So.
And your family's, like, kind of involved in the place, too, right?
Yeah, my wife, she does the bills, the payroll, my daughters do. Podium, they're all pitching in a little bit.
I remember, I didn't think your kids were old enough to work there, but I guess now the years have gone by, right?
Yeah, time flies when you're having fun.
It's incredible. But a family business is kind of a nice thing, too, right?
Yeah, there's not many left out there. So.
No, and that's kind of a cool thing. You get to be with your family and everything else.
Yep.
And you were brought up in a religious family, right?
Yes.
A Catholic family,
yep.
Which is nice. So you kind of have that tradition, too, that you pass on, right?
Yeah, we got married. We were St. Mary's. We got St. Anne's. You know,
I know
you were part of St. Anne's.
Yeah, and St. Mary's, too. Yeah, St. Mary's in East Islip.
Yep.
Yeah, great, great place. Good spots. So that, I love what you got here because this doesn't seem Italian to me. You have a big giant pretzel here.
Yes. Well, what we do is we've been out to dinner in a lot, you know, a bunch of places.
Sure, and that's one of the ways you kind of get ideas,
There's
right?
always pretzels out there hanging on the hooks with different cheese dips. I said, how could I get it into my restaurant?
It's interesting, yeah.
So I made a Bavarian antipasto. For Brunello's as an appetizer.
Yeah, yeah.
This will feed 4 to 8 people when it's done.
Wow.
And I put it in the restaurant as a special.
Yeah.
It took off. Now it's on the menu. People love it.
So. Really? Isn't that something?
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Well, how do you start? Now, these
All
pretzels,
right.
you know, I know you can get, I don't think like we can get these pretzels. You can get these
right.
pretzels.
Right. This pretzel here is from J. King's.
Right.
These are Bavarian pretzels. They are imported.
Yep.
So they are the real deal.
Yeah, yeah.
And we baked them. We just give a little mist and then we get started. You just spray the pan.
And those are like the monster pretzels, which are great,
too. Yeah, yeah.
And I got to tell you the truth. Like even I always keep some pretzels in the freezer because I think they're a nice snack kind of thing, you know?
Yeah, they are good.
And they're not the worst thing on earth for you.
Then we take the kosher salt and you just sprinkle it on.
When I was a kid, there was a pretzel guy, like, in outside. We had, like, a little South Bay shopping center. It was a walk-outside kind of place. And there was a pretzel guy just with a little stand there with charcoal. I can remember that smell to this day, you know?
Then we bake them in the oven for about 3-4 minutes.
So you can stick them in there. That's great. I'm noticing some of the other ingredients you have here, too, which is kind of looks... This looks amazing because this does not look very Bavarian to me.
That's right.
Like you're bringing
the
homeland.
This is
in.
The twist. So we have some salami Genoa, some soppressata, some thin cut prosciutto. Then we have artichokes, stuffed cherry peppers with provolone and prosciutto, some fresh mozzarella, roasted peppers. Then we have some diced tomatoes, olives, and then cubed provolone, some red onions, basil. We're going to finish it all up with that, and
Incredible.
It's going to come out amazing.
That is something else. I remember I visited you one time, Domenick, and you actually, you know, you're taking me a little tour of your kitchen, which his kitchen is like an operating room.
Still is.
I would expect. Yeah, this is just your nature. You're so incredibly neat and clean. What time do you get in there to start prepping?
We get in there at 11:30 during the afternoons.
Wow.
And Monday we're closed. So.
Yeah.
And then... We have lunch Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, 11:30 to 3, and then dinner time is 4:30 to 9 and then 4:30 to 10 p.m. on Friday and Saturdays.
Wow, so it's amazing. So, I mean, it is a lot of prep because you're doing everything by hand. I mean, there's nothing pre-made necessarily. You're not buying anything already done.
The only
right?
thing I think that we have pre-made is peas, and it's frozen peas. But everything else is made fresh. The mozzarella, we stuff the cherry peppers. The artichoke hearts, they come in, but they're imported from Italian, which the company importer. I use. It's an Italian importer.
They're
amazing. So everything I have here, even my cherry, the roasted peppers, we do ourselves.
You do yourself.
You know, I have the reds and the yellows, so we mix it up so it's a beautiful look. And
so it's unique,
you're going to love it.
And it's worth that investment. I mean, it's like that kind of, that pays off in the end, I think, because when people come into your place, they realize this is all homemade stuff that you have here, right?
Yep.
And now, were you always in the restaurant world? You were, right?
Yeah, since high school.
Since high school.
Yeah, I started off as a dishwasher. I think I washed dishes for like 2 weeks, and then I started cooking after they saw what I could do.
Yeah, I was a dishwasher for a while, too. I started at Leonard's of Great Neck, which is a big catering place, you know? And then, but then I fell in love with the other side of it, and I think there's something fun about the food part of it all, you know?
Yeah, you like to cook.
Yeah, I love to cook. I love to cook. And I think that's a great thing, too.
Yep.
It's a great, great gift. Now, were you involved in other restaurants, too, or what?
Years ago, I worked in a restaurant in Bayshore called Il Garofano's, which is the Carnation in Italian.
Okay.
That was in Bayshore.
Okay.
I was there for years, and then in 89, I went to Vinnie's Mulberry Street in Babylon Village.
Isn't that fun?
And I've been with them ever since, and then over the years,
kind of grew into your
own
place.
Getting into Brunello's with Vinnie, and then Vinnie retired.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm on my own now. I'm on my own about 2 years now.
Wow, that's
great.
Which
is nice.
Because these Mulberry Streets, you know, for those of you who are watching like someplace else, what happened is they kind of popped up. There were a number of them on Long Island.
Right.
And they became super popular. And they're like family places where families feel comfortable, blah, blah. And a lot of beautiful things kind of developed from this nice family that started this up.
Yep.
And then I guess you kind of got involved there, but then you grew into your own place. And you kind of fashioned some of that. I think the style is sort of fashioned after that, like the family atmosphere, the ability to have people. So you can have like a beautiful date night at your place, but you can also bring your family.
Yeah, especially on Sundays. Night. Sundays is a family day. There's
That's
kids
beautiful.
Running around, and it's a nice day. And then Friday and Saturday night, you know, friends, couples.
Right, going out, catching
in,
up and
catching,
stuff.
You know, it's a really good thing.
I was there, it was one of those nights. Mm-hmm. I think I was there like on a Thursday night, and it was beautiful.
Right.
It was just, you know, couples and friends together sharing, having a great meal. That stuff makes all the difference in the world.
Okay, we're ready to pull the pretzel.
All right, let's go. Okay. Let's get that Bavarian pretzel and introduce it to the Italian world. It's an interesting combination, that's for sure. And like I said, I love this. I love the smell of pretzels.
All right.
Brings me back to being a kid. Also brings me back to like being outside of Penn Station in the wintertime. You always got this smell of pretzels all over the place. Beautiful.
So it's got a nice little crust to it. It's soft.
Yeah, that's nice. It smells great, too. Now, this is an interesting thing. Like, I want to see how you build this.
So now, here we go. We're going to take one section. It's going to have all the cold cuts.
Oh, that's how you do. This is so interesting. Yeah. Wow. Now, did you just think this up or what? How'd this come out?
Yeah, well, I was trying to figure out how to get it into my store because when you go out, what do you see everywhere? There's pretzels everywhere, whether it's a sports bar, you know, or
you know, I sometimes go like to the cidery in Riverhead. My dad likes to go there, so I go there with him. And they have a big giant pretzel, but you just dip it into the cheese, you know.
Right. So then we take that, then we go here.
That's one of my favorite things on the planet, by the way, what you got there.
The stuffed cherries.
Oh, boy, I love these guys. I don't know if you've had a stuffed cherry pepper, but they're a little spicy, and yet at the same time, a little vinegar, and then you got a little piece of cheese and prosciutto in there. Your whole meal packed into one thing. I love it.
Then we take our fresh mozzarella, and we give a little slice.
Now, is your family a little bit like, are they kind of like food critics for you, or what?
When we go out, they're food critics, I'll tell you that. They're worse than I am.
Oh, really, yeah?
But
that's nice, though, right? It's a good thing.
They take after me.
Now, are your daughters studying, too, or what? They're still in school?
My daughters, two of them are graphic designers.
Wow, wait.
And one of them's in her last year of high school, so we're not really sure what she's going to be doing
yet. Not yet. That's amazing. Look how beautiful this is. This looks
terrific. We're just putting it together right here. We're going to put our artichokes with the roasted peppers. There's a little fresh garlic in there.
Mm.
Going to put a little salt and pepper.
Look how nice this looks.
And a little olive oil.
I can see what you're talking about, feeding a lot of people with this, because this is like all of a sudden.
And we mix it up, and it's going to go right here in this section.
Gee whiz, look at this. This looks great. Amazing.
Okay. I'll put this back.
And this is the other thing I like, too, Dom. Like, you're doing this all by order. These aren't all sitting around waiting to come out, right?
Nope, all by order. Some olives. Put this down nice. We take a little bit of red onions. Look how we go nice all that around.
Looks. Wow, those are beautiful too.
We take great. Some shaved Parmesan.
I can't believe
it's loaded. It's loaded.
It's like anti-Oktoberfest.
Then we take a little bit of basil, a little chiffonade, nice thin slice. Put it over the cheese sections, make a little mozza tomato section.
Yeah, exactly right.
And just a little more oil on that. Then we take our balsamic glaze. Let me just wipe this up so it's nice and clean here.
Look how beautiful that looks. The colors are so great on this.
And then we do a little garnish, the balsamic.
Wow, look how that's incredible.
Okay, here you have Brunello Italian Kitchen.
I just think this
Bavarian
is awesome.
Bavarian pretzel antipasta.
And this is like a great, good idea, great TV recipe because it looks beautiful and it looks nothing like I would have expected it to look. This is just awesome. This is a great, great dish. We're visiting with Chef Domenick Maresca from Brunello. We're going to take a break. I think he's got more up his sleeve, so stick around.
The Catholic Faith Network Green Room was provided by Lane Office, your workspace built with integrity.
Welcome back to Real Food. I know that looks beautiful. It took everything I had not to jump into that during the commercial break because it is absolutely beautiful. I'm with Chef Domenick Maresca. He's from Brunello Italian Kitchen. That was a great one, I got to tell you.
Good. I'm glad you
really,
liked it.
Really beautiful. Good. And I you took me by surprise with that because here's a Bavarian pretzel that becomes
an Italian
twist.
It's
sort of like my life. I'm half Italian, but the Italian took over.
Yes.
You know, and the same story here, Bavarian pretzel, but the Italian took over. So I love that.
Good, good. I'm glad you liked it.
Very, very nice. I noticed here, I mean, when I came in, this, I have to confess to you, Dom, this is my favorite meat.
Okay.
So veal is my favorite meat of all the meats God made. Nice. And I eat mostly chicken, but when I want to treat myself or go someplace have dinner, veal chop I love, you know?
We have a 16-ounce center cut veal chop.
That's a monster. I mean, that, in the world of veal, that's a giant, that's a giant piece of
meat. Delicious. So we're going to make this today. We're going to pan, sear it. It's Frenched.
Yeah.
It's very simple, a little salt and pepper on both sides. We're going to sear it up, get it ready for the oven to finish it. And then we're going to saute up a little topping for it and finish it up with a little mushroom demi.
Wow.
And the demi is made up with a little brown sauce and my short ribs that I made on the first episode.
No, I love
the
those.
Gravy out of the short ribs is mixed in there for that extra special taste.
I don't know if you had a residual after that, but people kept telling me that they went there and they had the short ribs and they absolutely loved them. Did people come in and
they
stuff?
They were coming in. They were like so happy. It was really nice. Yeah. The turnout was good.
And those short ribs are unbelievable. I mean, we shouldn't forget the short ribs because they're awesome.
And everybody loves you, by the way.
Ah, that's
they
nice.
All talk highly of you.
Ah, that's nice. That's nice. So how do we get this going?
All right,
what are we doing?
We're going to get a little heat on this pan now.
And that's good because a nice hot pan really helps in this world.
So basically, we're going to just a little seasoning of salt and pepper. You could put garlic powder if you like. It's preference.
I like to keep it the way God meant it to be. You know.
Okay, so this is nice and easy. We got the heat on here.
And what kind of oil you have in there? Like, you have to have a high heat oil, right?
Yeah, this is a 75-25.
Okay.
It's 25 olive oil, 75 canola.
Yes,
it handles the heat really nice, and it has a nice flavor to it also.
Yeah, exactly right.
So basically, we're going to put it in here. We're going to get it started.
Nice sizzle on that. Oh, yeah, that sounds great. That's beautiful.
But
now,
you
are
want
you testing
sizzle.
This stuff out during the day? How do you get this stuff going?
Well, this has been tested. Just like the pretzel was.
Yeah.
And then it was put on the menu after it was run on specials.
Okay.
When you make a special and it runs and everybody likes it, you put a nice check mark next to it and say sold
well. Don't forget that one,
And then when you revamp the menu, you take off the dead stuff and you put on the new stuff.
That's a good way to do it.
And you do it every 6 months, you know, usually seasonal, you'll change stuff.
Okay.
The winter, I might change some, you know, one or two items.
Get it, yeah.
And
I thought maybe if you had a little testing committee, I could join that somehow.
You can come anytime and test anything you like.
All right, I don't mind testing. You know, I'm good at testing. That's fine. But you're a very creative. You're a very creative chef. So that's what I kind of like about
this.
It's kind of different. You know,
and
it's kind of cool.
And we're gonna take a few mushrooms, just cut them up, get them ready for the sauce. I got some red onion, which we used on the pretzel. You could use shallot.
Yeah, sure.
Red onion does the same thing.
But red onion, you know, what's nice about red onion, too, it's a little less harsh.
Right.
Right, and it has a little sweetness to it, too, right off the bat.
So and it works well in the sauce also.
Yeah,
so.
I can imagine. That's nice.
So we're going to put that there. And these, I just quarter them.
So they're still going to have a little chunk to them, which is nice. They're not going to disappear.
Yeah, and it looks nice on top of this.
Yeah, I like that.
On top of it when it's done. Gives it a little substance.
Now, Domenick, you're in the community a while now, so has the community come out and ask for your help, I'm sure, by now?
Oh, everybody comes in every day. We give a lot of gift certificates out for charities, and we did Deer Park Kids Youth baseball league.
Yeah, sure. You know, St. Cyril's Church is right there, right?
Yeah, St. Cyril's.
And the school.
Which is, it's a good thing. So everybody comes in and, you know, everybody needs a little something in the town. But and then they support you.
Of course, they come back,
which is nice.
And that's how a town really functions, right? You know,
yes.
It's like the locals coming too. I mean, you get people from all over Long Island coming to your restaurant, but it's the locals too that matter, right?
Yeah.
And I'm sure you have regulars that are there, right?
Yeah, we do. It's nice. But you see a lot of people that when we first opened, you know, they came in, and then all of a sudden now you start seeing them weekly or every other week, and they have parties. Now you're starting to get like baby showers and communions.
And you do all of that too?
Yeah, so we do showers, parties like that, Saturdays and Sundays. The rooms are open from 12 to 4.
Oh, great.
You know, so we do a lot of that.
That's good for people to know, because it's sometimes hard to find a place. The other thing I like about your place, just a practical reality, is there's lots of parking, which is a big help too. And that's sometimes tough. Like parking can be a pain in the neck.
We have a side street parking lot, which is nice, and then around the building. But parties are good. When parties are taken, you have the restaurant to yourself. They come in, they decorate, they make the restaurant look beautiful.
Oh, that's nice, too.
So
that's
I don't hold them back. It's their day. They enjoy the
party. Yeah, that's a very nice thing to do. That's a very nice thing.
So basically, we want to get a nice color on the bottom of the steak.
You can see already it's starting,
It's getting nice. You want a golden brown. And then when we put it in the oven, the other side that we flip it onto is going to get a real nice crust.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we'll pull it out, and we're going to make a little sauce in a minute. So we're going to flip it.
And this is not a stuffing necessarily either. This is all over it, right?
Yeah, this is basically
like
going to be on top.
To be honest with you,
Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to put this in the oven.
Now, do you keep this at a high heat? What do you keep this at?
The oven right now is at 500 degrees here.
So you just let
it go. In the restaurant, it's going to be a little hotter.
Yeah.
The oven's...
That's amazing.
We're about 550, 600 in the restaurant.
So you really get it going.
Yes.
That's nice.
All right, and then we're going to get ready, and we're going to start making our sauce.
And this is, like, in some ways a little traditional as far as the, so like your brown gravy, per se.
Right.
I mean, you're making that. That's like you say, a byproduct of the...
Yes, we make a stock brown sauce, some bones, and we add some vegetables, and then we're done. It, you know, we reduce it down.
Sure.
And then we use that for our carne dishes, which is our veal, and to that effect, when we're done with it, we refrigerate it, and then we use this. We make our short ribs, and we use the short rib gravy.
Yeah, that's unbelievable.
Now, the short rib gravy gets mixed in with the brown sauce when we make certain dishes. That just adds, like, that extra flavor, which is really good.
And the short rib gravy becomes a very dark and,
it's delicious.
Yeah, it's just so real. It's beautiful.
All right.
So a little butter and a little bit of oil.
A little butter, a little oil. We're going to get it to heat up a little bit, which is nice that we have a nice gas stove now, which is great.
Your needs, Domenick, are my demand. That's it. I just get it done. Whatever you want. It's no problem.
All right, so we get a little bit of the mushrooms going.
Now, your parish is, where do you live?
I'm in Islip, so my parish is St. Mary's.
Oh, yeah, St. Mary's still. That's nice. Good.
Which is nice.
That's where I started my priesthood.
It's a beautiful parish.
Yeah, and I had a great time there. It was a wonderful community there.
All my girls went through there. It's very nice.
And then you also talk about restaurants. I mean, that area of Long Island is really packed with restaurants over there, right? There's a lot of restaurants there.
Yep.
It's interesting.
So then we just spice it. Nothing crazy, just a little salt and pepper.
But the salt will draw some liquid out of the mushrooms,
yes,
right?
It will.
And that helps start the sauce, so to speak, I guess,
yep.
Right? That's amazing. That's nice. And are you using salted or unsalted butter?
This is salted butter. I use salted. I know a lot of people use it unsalted.
Yeah.
I just like the flavor that it emits out
of
it.
Fan.
Yes.
I'm a fan of salted, too. I don't know. And a lot of the chefs we have on, and all of you are great chefs, I understand that, they'll use the unsalted, but I don't know, for me, my whole life, I'm so used to the taste of salted butter.
Yeah.
I like it a lot in there.
We'll throw the onions in now. We don't want to put them in right away because they will burn. So we'll get them going nice.
And you got that on a high heat. One of the things I like too, Domenick, this is your tool here. So I don't know a lot of chefs who use this, the tweezers, but you could do pretty much anything with that, right?
Yeah, these are called plating tweezers. Finishing tweezers, but I use it for everything.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Once you get used to it, you could do anything.
It's incredible.
Really good.
Yeah.
So
I mean, you're cooking all night with those, right?
Yes. Incredible. Just like, here you go, rag in one hand, this in the other.
Incredible, yeah.
Yep.
And what's nice about that, you don't really have to change that out very much because... That'll do your flipping. That'll do everything for you, right?
Yes.
Interesting. Somebody gifted me with one of those one time, but I have to tell you, it's in the drawer because it's hard for me to get used to it.
These are about 20 years old.
Really?
Yeah, the other ones, the spring tongs, they break.
Yeah, the spring tongs.
It doesn't work.
And they start to hurt your hands after a while.
All right, so we got this going. We're going to use a little bit of red wine. This is a cab. This is my house cab, which you can use any red wine, a Merlot, a Cabernet.
But what you like to drink, pretty much.
Whatever you like to drink and whatever's in your house is good. Just a little bit in there.
And off begins the sauce right away.
Yes.
It's amazing.
Then you bring it down a little bit because it brings out the sugars in the wine.
Now, are you picking out all the wines, too, for the place, or what?
I pick out some, but I have one of my managers who runs the bar.
Who really
she
is good.
She does it, and she's really good at what she does. So.
Yeah, that's nice. That's good.
Okay, so this is the brown sauce that went in there. I'm going to bring it down
wine,
a little
remember?
Bit.
And that just looks so shiny right off the bat. It's incredible how nice that is.
And then this here, just a little stock to loosen it. We'll put a little parsley in there because that's what we do.
Man, look how nice that is. That's just turning out absolutely beautiful. What an amazing thing.
And you got about 2 minutes, and that'll come down. We bring it down so it's a little creamy consistency.
Yeah.
We'll pull the chop out of the oven, and we'll finish it.
All right, you know what we'll do? Why don't we take a little break right now? We'll let this finish up. When we get back, it'll be veal time. And veal time and meal time. You can't go wrong. Stick around. More real food right after this. Welcome back, everybody. So the smell of caramelization is in the air. I mean, you could just smell that meat caramelizing,
yes.
too.
The it's veal, awesome. It's delicious. That's all flavor.
Yeah,
all
that's
flavor.
What that's about.
Yep.
And again, like to do give a veal chop its justice, to give any real chop its justice, it needs that crusty
yes.
kind of, that's what makes it so great. Yeah. That's why I like them grilled, yeah. because, you know, you automatically get it. If you can't
yep.
get your oven to do this,
yep.
you know, that's awesome.
Yeah, and at home, you could use a grill pan. If
sure.
you don't have to go outside, if you don't want to, you can use, and you could do that.
Yeah.
A flat pan with a little oil like we did here works well, and then finish in the oven. You'll never finish it in a pan because
right.
you have to get the center a little cooked. So
yeah.
we like to serve it medium, always the best.
That's why I like it too.
But you also, you know, a lot of people do like different temperatures.
A little
so
further
whatever
up,
you
yeah.
prefer at home, you could cook it to anywhere.
I mean,
you
the
like.
Barbecue, like I said, what I like about the barbecue is it gets up to 700.
Yeah.
So you can really go to town like you can in your
yeah.
restaurant every day.
Yep.
At home, it's hard for us to get
yes.
that temperature in our ovens,
yep.
you know?
But we're ready to go.
All right, let's go. Let's get
All right,
that thing
let's
going.
Let's get our plate out here.
So another beautiful plate ready to go.
All right, here we go.
Now, and again, you see in this oven, you could just see, look at this. It's just caramelizing and caramelizing. Oh, man. Look how beautiful that looks, huh? Wow. Incredible. And it's just sizzling. And again, this is not all, you know, gopped up with all kinds of sauce and everything.
Right.
This is just salt and pepper on this guy. And he's just been in the oven. Just, oh, beautiful.
See?
Look at that. Yeah,
that's what happens. That's what you want. That's all flavor, the caramelization.
Look at the beauty of that, boy. That's great.
Then we have our sauce.
And again,
and
this has gotten
go.
Rich because this is broken down. And
we finish it
oh,
up
look
with
at
a
that.
Beautiful mushroom
caramelized and come together, concentrated.
Then we're going to take a little fried onion straws.
Well, that would be the piece de resistance, as we say. Build it up.
And then we're going to just a little color to it.
Yeah, that's great. Now, is this a special? What's on the menu, Dominic?
This is on the menu. This is Brunello's 16-ounce veal chop
yeah.
with a mushroom demi azu.
That's beautiful. Congratulations on a beautiful, beautiful, oh, that's just terrific. It's a great thing. Brunello's a place that reminds me, you know, it's gathering around the table with family and friends, but sometimes it's about going out to the special places, too. You know, Brunello's a special place. It's a place that, yeah, you can go there on a weeknight. You go there every week, for that matter. But you want to celebrate something. You want to go out. You don't always have to go to one of the big cities where you live. You can just go in the neighborhood sometimes and find these expert chefs, you know, that are doing it a different way. So it's a great, great gift. I want to thank you for coming.
And I want to thank you for
you.
Having me.
Oh,
I appreciate
it's great to
it
have
always.
You. Believe me.
Thank you.
Tell me the website so we can get people go
it's
there.
It's BrunelloItalianKitchen.com.
Okay, that's
All
it.
Right.
BrunelloItalianKitchen.com. Visit it. They have a good website. It's kind of fun. So take a look there. They have the pictures. I always like the pictures.
Yes, and you're on there. So
I'm in there too?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's even better yet. So there you go. Do that as well. So we ask the Lord to bless us, our tables, and our work before we take leave today. So let us pray. Loving God, you give us so many gifts, and we ask you to bless our family and our friends and all of the gifts that we have in our lives and the gift of work that calls us together and helps us to support one another. Bless our sacred tables at home and in our churches and help us to serve you every day of our lives in so many ways. Help us to use our gifts, Lord, every day and bless these meals, which we ask your blessing upon through Christ our Lord. Thanks for being with us, everybody. If you want this recipe, you want to find out more information, you can email us at realfood@cfntv.org. We'll be happy to share it with you. And until next time, we'll see you again on Real Food. God bless, everybody.
Msgr Food and its brand Vantia are proud to support Real Food. Find Vantia cheese, cured meats, olive oil, and Italian specialty foods in your local supermarket or email us at info@msgrfood.com for a list of retailers near you. Real Food set and appliances has been provided by Chufo Cabinetry, a family tradition of fine woodworking since 1907. Chufo Cabinetry has been filling the custom cabinetry needs of the New York tri-state area for over 100 years by combining old-world techniques with modern technology to provide the finest custom kitchens and millwork. Luxury appliance innovators Sub-Zero, Wolf, and Cove. Cosentino, a Spanish company world leader in the production and distribution of innovative surfaces for architecture and design. Silestone, Decton, and Sensa by Cosentino. Technologically advanced surfaces that allow the creation of unique designs for the home and public spaces. Blackman Plumbing Supply. Visit a Blackman showroom today and let their specially trained design consultants help you find the luxury plumbing, tile, lighting, and stone products you need to make your project a success. Top Knobs, the designer's choice.